Ultra detailed image to 3D AI just got better. More accurate details, better texturing, more convenient UI, and better 3D reconstruction. That sounds promising, but we're gonna test if it's really that good. Guys, Steph here, and we're checking Hightem version 2 today. Before we start to take a look in the update, let's understand what Hightem is about. Early this year, these guys announced Spark 3D, which actually made some noise, some new way of 3D reconstruction, which showed anime. Amazing attention to details. I'm gonna say like 6 months ago, it was top one in terms of details. Continuation of that became Hightem 3D with version 1, then version 1.5, which is amazing. I really like this one. And this December, just before the new year, they dropped the present for us, which is version 2.0. So they updated UI. It's more convenient. Right now we have image to 3D, multi-view to 3D. We can choose the version 2.0, 1.5, 1. Version 2 only has 2 resolutions, but version 1.5 has all 4 resolutions if you need it. So you can generate it with texture, without, and they also updated portrait mode. Now it supports multi-view, which we're gonna test as well. So key thing why everyone actually get crazy about it is a lot of details and very, very sharp geometry. So we can take a look on example like this, and you can see how many details, how sharp they are. And I mean, this is insane. This is like version 1.5 with 1536p Pro resolution. I mean, looks like a crazy amount of details. And now they just dropped Hightem 3D 2.0, higher fidelity reconstruction, unified texture generation, and overall improvements. Now, of course, I did plenty of tests already, and I have a lot to say. Let's take a look on some good examples first. And everything with a lot of small details, such as this dragon, looks just amazing, guys. Not gonna lie, this is insane. And if I turn on the solid mode, you can see that everything is basically geometry within just 2 million faces. Of course, this is not about amount of polygons, it's about the accurate reconstruction, like basically high poly models. And I would say this is my top one still, and it just got better in this. I also did some tests with some other objects when there's a mix of organic and hard surfaces, and it also looked very, very nice. So like, take a look at this boot. Wow, I mean, this is really good, right? Even inside part is okay. Let's take a look at this tower. You can see like all lines sharp, amazing work, right? Woo. The hollow part inside too. What interesting choice. Unexpected, but very interesting. And pretty much everything with a lot of details is doing really, really great. Surprisingly, this guy is really good. This is probably one of the best 3D reconstruction I saw of this 4 creature. I tested this prompt with all another 3D AI, and the results are not that great. So here you can see the Hightem 2.0 and, like, for example, Hunyuan 3. We can compare, for example, same prompt with Trellis. Yeah, Trellis actually really overthink it, right? Like, tries to do reconstruction, but again, yeah, the 4 is challenging, I would say. And here on top, 3D AI, as usual, you can compare all the models, all the prompts I showed in my videos with all other new models, such as, for example, Varco 3D from NCSoft, developers of Lineage 2. Can you imagine? They're also doing 3D AI. So these are like really good examples where version 2 is doing really, really good. But for example, if we start talking about organic stuff like characters and portraits, I'm not sure at all. So here is the character generation in Hightem 2.0 Pro in the max resolution. And if we compare it like with Hightem 1.5 and 2, I mean, it still has similar problems, like for example with eyes. And I would not say I see a lot of improvements. Also, texture and stuff look sharper. I of course tested another characters such as this one, and while I see some general improvements, I also see some inherited problems. So on this example, you can see that in terms of colors, it looks better, I think. Like, so the skin here is better, but in terms of details, I think it start to losing some details on texture. For example, here you can see these runes or stuff, they're present here, and here they are not present. Maybe it can start consider this like a special effect and remove it, but that's actually happening pretty often, like this example too. So you can see on my reference, there are vibrant colors and stuff, and version 1.5 actually tries to keep with this vibe. Colors, materials, I don't know, on version 2 are more flat in my opinion. There are another generation such as this orc. We can take a look here. In version 1.5, it's a little bit dark, maybe too dark. But yeah, the colors are more flat. Well, I must admit there are more details on the face. You can see every small scar or like wrinkles. They are done with geometry, which I guess is improvement. But to be honest, I really like more the orc from version 1. Just take a look here. Yes, maybe it's not that detailed, but in terms of texture, it's basically what I really want from this model, I guess. So in some cases, I'm not really happy with texture. And for very complex objects, such as this tree, for example, this is at least weird. It tries to put some leaves on top of the geometry. Well, I mean, that's not even close and that looks bad. Well, the base of the tree looks quite good. However, for this prompt, this works very nice. This is actually surprisingly extremely good. Look, it created with geometry some leaves and there's a base that adds volume. In general, this looks amazing as an asset. So if we compare it with version 1, it is not even close, right? It's way, way, way better. And following the prompt in terms of geometry especially, we can also compare it with version 1.5. And same problem, right? So here, the improvement is significant. In version 2, this prompt is outstanding. Similar goes to this one. Also a very, very, very nice result. Looked like every leaf is done impeccable. Just look at this. Wow. Of course, this is like very high poly geometry and you need to optimize it like before you can use it as a game asset or wherever you want to use it. But the reconstruction, and that's what we measure like in first place, is amazing. But again, some stuff with textures is really uncertain. I have this prompt and for some reason, it basically just removed the glyph. And colors are also a little bit darker than they are. Why this happened, I don't know. That's definitely not a good one. So we briefly touched the portraits. I think there is improvement. It follows really better, but in terms of textures and saturation, the colors, I'm not sure. I think it still needs fine-tuning. Here is our Timothy Chalamet. I don't think it's like really him. But close. Also, I tried multi-view for characters. So here, for example, is a character created with one view. Look, the backside and stuff. Some weird stuff here on nose and lips. Don't know why this happens. And basically, I created the same character with multi-view, which specifies what's on the back. So yes, it follows. And again, you really need multi-view if you need some specific details from areas that from prompt you. It's not necessarily mean that multi-view will give you better result. It will just guess less about back view and side view. So in this case, backside is exactly as on my side, but for sides, it's still messed up with all this rings, earrings, and stuff. Smile toy is still scary. And one thing more that I want to add is that some simple objects are quite bad. So I don't know like why it adds this flat shader effect on some surfaces. For example, this teapot. Even in version 1, it was smoother. Right, it actually started to appear since version 1.5, and my guess is that for a simpler object you definitely don't want to go with pro resolution. 1536p is more than enough, and overall I recommend choose that wisely, not only to save credits but to actually get maximum from item. Here's one more example, this quite simple object, and here you can see the version 1.5 and version 2. Some weird artifact here messing up with the color, with the backside. You can see version 1.5 also better. So for simple objects, I would not recommend to go with pro resolution at first, and second, definitely go with version 1.5. It does it better. So my conclusion is that for detailed object, for 3D printing, this is an amazing improvement, and I still recommend Hitem over all other AI for printing especially. But for general use, simple objects, I would still say 1.5 5 does it better in like half of the cases, and texture and colors in most of the cases I like in version 1.5 or 1. But I really think they will improve that. Also, what I really appreciate that developers do understand that really high poly models always still need ray topology, and you can see they added this ray topology. It's in beta now, but they're working on it. And for example, we can try to optimize this dragon to 15K, let's say quads, and they even do auto UV unwrap. So let's keep it like this. Let's run the ray topology and see what results we can get. Okay, ray topology was quite fast, and it also does baking, right? So it does ray topology and baking on top. So here we can see the results. Let's take a look on the mesh. I cannot check the mesh here, so I'm gonna download it as OPG. I dropped it to Blender and let's see the mesh. Here is how this quad ray topology looks. It would not be correct to call it ray topology. Like for example, Hunion trying to do ray topology. You can check out my other video about that. This is more like mesh optimization with baking, which is already good and might save you some time before transferring it to next software. And I'm really curious to see how they will improve this feature. Thanks for watching, guys. If you like this video, like and subscribe, and check out other videos about 3D AI tools and workflows.